Danny Kingad versus Xie Wei in the one flyweight division. This one is going to be something special.
Xie Wei came up through One Hero Series, which is the biggest search for China's next superstar. And Xie Wei could be that superstar. He went on a 5-match win streak. In his last 3 matches, he stopped his opponents in the very first round.
This is a man who has sent shockwaves throughout the ONE Championship community. He has a 100% finishing rate. If you're talking about earmarking a potential breakout star from China in 2020, it's Xie Wei.
Danny Kingad has a lot of weapons at his disposal. He can keep matches on the feet, pick you apart, outwork you in every single area. But then, if he wants to wrestle, Danny Kingad very well could be the best grappler Team Lakai has. And I think he's gonna showcase that evolved wrestling style in this matchup.
What a year he had, a breakout year in 2019. Danny Kingad went 3-1, and that one was his loss to Demetrius Johnson, the greatest of all time. But he took Demetrius Johnson the distance. That really did open the eyes of the world to what young Danny Kingad is capable of. Xie Wei is the master of finishing opponents. So what happens when the wrecking ball goes up against the hardest wall he's ever tried to go through? We are really going to see if Xie Wei of China is the real deal, is the hype for real, or will Danny Kingad derail the Chinese brilliance?
Let's stand. Ready? Ready? Go!
Is it going to be Kingad with his strikes? Will it be the BJJ ground game of Reece McLaren? This one brought to you by Red Horse. Look out for the wushu. On Kingad. Those five times, the cutting side kicks, the turning back kicks, the spinning back fists. McLaren driving, double leg takedown, gets it early. Can he keep Kingad down? And he does. This is where McLaren wants to be. This is McLarenville.
That's what we wanted to see, that double leg takedown. He initially went for that knee tap after some heavy strikes were thrown by Kingad, and then he slid underneath and got that double leg. Now he's in a very good position right now as he's trying to frame off the head of Danny Kingad and work into a better position. Let's see what his ground control is like.
The winner of this one goes through to the final to take on the winner of Demetrius Johnson and Tatsumitsu Wada, which is up next.
Let's see what Kingad can do. He's trying to hook that foot. Face to face. Good driving takedown there from McLaren as Kingad tried to get up.
Full mount now for Reece McLaren. Kingad unable to return to his feet. The Australian taking his time. Showing patience in the opening round here. This is exactly where McLaren wants to be. Nice stiff elbow under the chin there. And McLaren's eyebrow shot up as if to say, well, I didn't expect that.
Good job by Kingad to push that leg down and get back up to his feet as the crowd surging him on.
Loud crowd as always, sold out inside the Mall of Asia Arena. We had to turn them back at the door. It's the hottest ticket in town. ONE Championship on a Friday night in Manila. Their man, Danny Kingad, working off his back at the moment. Reece McLaren, top position.
Kingad was doing a good job in the pass. And a good job of getting back up and reversing the position.
Have a look at this. Kingad now top position. McLaren holding on to that net. Now gives up on it. What can Kingad do from here? Goes to the arm. Up and down. Armbar attempt from the King.
Kingad jumped in that armbar a little bit too soon. Risky move when they're dry like that. But I could see how he was going for it. He felt, because it's early in the round, they're not slippery, wouldn't be able to slip out, but submit Reece McLaren. Wow, what a shocker that would be, as McLaren's got the back now.
Breaking and crushing the face here of Kingad. Kingad breaks through. It's deafening inside the Mall of Asia Arena. At the outset of this Grand Prix tournament, momentum. He's got a second chance here tonight, a second bite of the cherry. Can he take full advantage of it? Can he capitalize? Has the back of Danny Kingad.
Kingad's doing a good job of defending his neck right now. You can see McLaren was right almost underneath that chin, and Kingad pushed that arm up a little bit. He's doing a good job of defending the hands right now, but he's giving McLaren those minute little opportunities just to adjust his position and keep threatening that choke. Danny Kingad has got to turn in, go body to body. Right now, it's gonna be hard for him to go to the left. He's gonna need to go to the right.
It started March 31st in Tokyo. It continued tonight in Manila. It finishes October 13 in Tokyo. The one championship Flyweight World Grand Prix. This is semi-final number one. Reece McLaren owning the back of Danny Kingad right now, trying to sink the choke. That will tap out the King. That will send McLaren through to Tokyo.
This is his chance to spin right now. Danny Kingad's going to have a hard time, you know, utilizing proper technique because Reece McLaren's so technically skilled. His opportunity is going to come from an explosion where he just violently turns into the body of Reece McLaren.
It's all survival for Danny Kingad. 55 seconds remaining in this opening round, set for three. And the young King glances around. He's receiving instructions from that star-studded corner of his. 45 seconds on the clock now. McLaren had his back for a long-term drive.
Good job. That choke's a little bit high still. Still in that face cranker. It's extremely uncomfortable. But Danny Kingad's not going to give up that easy. You can see if McLaren can get under that chin with his right arm, that's when that choke is going to sink in. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's just a face crank. It's just like squeezing your face. And there's the turn. Good job by Danny Kingad to at least end that round on his feet to reverse the position, end up inside the guard of McLaren, and then getting up. This is where Danny Kingad, I think, made a mistake. He gives up a very dominant position here to go chasing after that arm bar. And you can see he didn't quite have it. You can see him lock up the arm here, steps over the face. McLaren started to turn, but then McLaren gets that arm. He gets it up, his thumb is in the wrong position. He's able to slide the arm out. Risky move by Danny Kingad, but if you don't risk big, you can't win big, and that's what Kingad was doing. A submission over a BJJ black belt and a spot in the finals. How much better could his night get? But it's all for naught, and then Reece McLaren was able to control about 2 minutes of the groundwork there in that first round. But now we're starting back up on the feet, and that's where the striker likes to live.
Second round set for three, semi-final number one for the right to compete in the final in Tokyo on October 13 and take on either the greatest, Demetrius Johnson or Tatsu Mitsuwada in the final. A sold-out crowd going absolutely off their rockers inside the mighty Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. The outstanding kick from the Wushu champion, Danny Kingad. And again, he sent a big tuck thumper into the thigh of Reece McLaren.
That's two low leg kicks there by Danny Kingad. You can see Reece McLaren tries to ride the leg kick by lifting his leg up, and it throws him a little bit off balance. Kingad might be able to fire a right hand in here. Nice little trip. You can see Kingad tried to sweep out the leg with a low kick, and Reece McLaren fell into the takedown there as he's now in side control.
Not where Kingad wanted to be. Reece McLaren, top position on him this early in the round.
Reece McLaren sliding that leg through there, easily passes. Now into side control, goes north-south, and Kingad turtles over, trying to take a single leg there.
Side leg kick from Kingad. The King showing dominance in the standout. McLaren wants him on the ground. He gets him on the ground. The BJJ black belt now in top position.
Kingad was doing good work. That was a beautiful break in the action right there as McLaren slows down Kingad. Kingad was landing some heavy leg kicks, scoring with some big hooks. McLaren didn't like it. Now he's got the top position, and now he's slowly inching up in the front. There's that explosion from Kingad to just get one butterfly hook in and to kind of secure a little bit of a half guard now. Now he's got to try to get McLaren onto the other side and start working back up to his feet.
Folks, make sure you follow ONE Championship on all your social media, on Instagram, Facebook, and on Twitter. Use the hashtag ONE Championship on Twitter. Let us know where you're watching from. Takes the back here. Does Reece McLaren, can he get those hooks in there? Kingad goes turtle shell, now spins onto his back. McLaren top position, 220 remaining. Second round of three. Elbow there for the King. This has been an absolute ripper. A thrilling contest. Semi-final number one for the right to go through to the final of the Flyweight World Grand Prix October 13 in Tokyo, Japan. And face either the great Demetrius Johnson or Tatsumitsu Wada.
Danny Kingad right now, he's gone through five unanimous decision victories in his last five matches since that loss to Adriel Marias. He is a judge's favorite. But right now, he's going to have to do something much more significant than getting put on his back like this. He's got to keep this on the feet. He's got to get back up to his feet and start doing more damage on the feet, especially with the uppercuts. Nice job by Danny Kingad to reverse the position. Now he's on top trying to pass the guard of Lightning.
Mitch, if Danny Kingad can stop Reece McLaren, I fear for our eardrums. They will explode with the noise this arena will make for the King.
Can your ears get much worse than they already are, though?
No. Top position for the King.
Oh, look at Reece. Transition into a leg lock. Looking for the heat, looking for the hooks. Can't quite get it. Gets a calf slicer, though. Look at the calf here. Look at the left leg of Danny Kingad. This is a bad. Look at McLaren using it as a sweep, but he ends up in kind of a darce choke from the bottom here. By
this is like a crazy game of Twister at the moment, all tied up in a knot, tangled knee to the side of the head there from Lightning Reece McLaren, the Australian.
Nothing.
30 seconds remain. Second round of three. Semi-final number one. Reece trying to hop onto the back and ride the King again.
Beautiful balance by Reece McLaren as he's almost falling through the ring ropes there. Danny Kingad's got to be very careful here. He's got to end up in a little bit more dominant position just to secure some points here. Reece McLaren's doing very well in his ground exchange as he takes the back. That's ground control right there, ladies and gentlemen.
Final seconds of this round. I see seesawing back and forth in Kingad. Wherever you're watching around the world live in over 140 countries, hope you're enjoying all the action. Big hello to John, watching from the Bronx, New York in the USA.
Danny Kingad getting it ready for the third round. This has typically been his round where he does a lot of his best work. But Reece McLaren is controlling a lot of the ground exchanges. His ground control, that's the thing. He's not just holding Danny Kingad down once he gets the pass, once he gets the takedown. He's moving and advancing his position. We're seeing side control. We're seeing mount. We're seeing a variety of positions, getting the back, trying the submission attempts. That is ground control, ladies and gentlemen. And he is showing it beautifully.
This semi-final surpassing all expectations. We are seeing a classic here in front of a sold-out crowd inside the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. The ONE Championship Flyweight World Grand Prix, semi-final number one. The winner will go through to the final in Tokyo at the Ryogoku Kokugi on October 13 to take on either Demetrius Johnson or Tatsumitsu Wada. It is still anyone's for the taking. Wide southpaw stance on Reece McLaren, trying to get inside the mind of Danny Kingad. McLaren will do that. He'll play psychological games. He'll try and psych you out in the ring. Top position for the Filipino. And here comes the ground and pound. McLaren back to his feet. Up again for Kingad.
Kingad's moment right here.
He went for the headache maker. And Reece pointing, saying that one threw out of the arena. Good snappy jab there from the Aussie.
Confidence is high on Reece McLaren right now. He's starting to let it all hang out. Then you guys see that character that we've known to grow and love in one championship. This is Danny Kingad's moment.
McLaren double leg. Can he sit him down? Kingad staying vertical. Now he's horizontal.
Good job by Reece McLaren to clasp those hands underneath the hips. Drive down to the takedown. It was smart. He could have picked him up and went for one of those exaggerated takedowns, so to speak, but he saved that energy. He conserved it, and he just gently put him down on his backside. Now he's in mount again, dropping a little bit of ground and pound. Beautiful groundwork by Reece McLaren.
3 minutes, 10 remaining. Will McLaren be the first one through to the final in Tokyo? What a marvelous flyweight World Grand Prix it's been. And this has been one of the highlight matches. I'll tell you what, folks, this has been something spectacular.
See, McLaren's doing something with his takedowns. He's not just taking down and laying and praying. He's trying to advance the position. He's trying to finish. He's trying to go for submissions. Danny Kingad, oh, that's a very uncomfortable position there with that leg trap like that. Now he's setting up that Dars. Look at that chokes. He's got a little bit of a choke there. Good job by Danny Kingad to kind of force his back to the ground to get Reece McLaren to let that go.
Kingad back to his feet. Okay, Danny Kingad, top position. McLaren goes, yep, I'm here. Let's see what you can do. 2 minutes, 15 remains. Third and final round. Posting up with that left arm, McLaren. Taking his time. Deep breath for the Australian. Kingad wants to keep him on the ground.
Let's see, Reece McLaren's trying to think about getting up. He's trying to use that post, work his way back up. It's a lot more difficult with the ring ropes. They don't have that circle wall to start working up on. So the ring ropes actually favor Kingad in this position right here. He can trap McLaren on the ground. See how he's trapped here? He laced that leg. Now he's going to try to scoop the hips away from the ring ropes.
Back to the feet now. And Kingad with the knees, with the elbows in close. It's the neck to the outside thigh, McLaren, and another one. Trying to tenderize, trying to cork the quadriceps. Around the back of the hamstring, the sciatic nerve. Who's the leg here? Kingad.
Beautiful takedown there by Danny Kingad. I told you, his wrestling is a completely different level. He utilizes it very well. Look at him using it offensively against the BJJ black belt. And he's almost in mount. Let's see how Reece McLaren gets out of this.
Kingad looking to drop the anvils on the jaw of McLaren. Under a minute remaining. Self-control, he cuts the hip in, drops the elbow, and there's another one. The ground and pound from the king. This place is erupting. Knees now to the body of McLaren, to the arm of McLaren. Elbows again to the orbital, go the fists. Side control, the shoulder thrust to the orbital now. Kingad staying busy, drops the hands on him again. There are the knees from the king, driving the patella into the ribcage of Reece McLaren.
He's trying to get back up, he's trying to get back up to his feet. Ladies and gentlemen, we do not judge round by round, we judge a match on its entirety. How is Kingad ending this match right now?
The final salvos from Danny Kingad. And we are going down to the judges here in the middle of this one. It was epic. And look at the moment of respect. Two athletes who gave it their all. Who will go through the final?
Hands on their knees, completely exhausted, left it all in the ring. Nothing to be ashamed of. They gave it everything they had. Beautiful performance by two incredible flyweight warriors. Look at Kingad. You can see Reece McLaren tries to get underneath with the butterfly hooks, and you can see Reece McLaren elevated him, but beautiful balance and control shown by Kingad as he was able to float over and sit on top there in side control. Did a lot of good work in that first round, or that set third round, but was it enough to make up for the work and the ground control that Reece McLaren had in the first two rounds? And it comes down to the end. It's so tough to call. It's so tough. But let's go up to the judges and find out. Michael Schiavello, your thoughts.
Sold out inside the wall of Asia Arena. They will go absolutely off their nuts if Danny Kingad gets the nod here. A close one. Did McLaren do enough on the ground to edge it? The right to go through the final in Tokyo in October. Let's go to Tom Lau and find out who's through first.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one scores this contest in favor of the blue corner. Judge number two scores this contest in favor of the red corner. And judge number three calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision and advancing to the one Flyweight World Grand Prix final from the
Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.